far reaches of Nunavut, in the Canadian Arctic archipelago, lies the Northwest Passage, a long sought-after sea link that connects the northern Atlantic and Pacific oceans. For centuries, Inuit, the indigenous people of the region, had traversed the passage with dog sleds and small boats. But could a ship navigate the Northwest Passage? For hundreds of years, European adventurers risked their lives to find out if they could do just that. The connection between the two oceans would, in turn, open up maritime transportation between Europe and Asia. It took a few centuries and cost a few hundred lives, but the Northwest Passage was finally transited in 1906. Roald Amundsen made history by reaching the Bering Strait after 3 years of travel through the Arctic. By the time Amundsen made the passage, it had already proved to be impractical as a sea route. The icy and treacherous conditions of the Canadian Arctic challenged even the most skilled sailors, like those who had sailed on the doomed voyage of Sir John Franklin in 1845. The completion of the Panama Canal in 1914 made the Northwest Passage an even less attractive option as a shortcut between east and west. Although the canal route was longer, for most voyages at least, it was far safer and more reliable than the Northwest Passage. But with recent climate change trends, the Arctic sea ice that had proven so formidable in the early 1900s has been depleting. That's led many to wonder whether the Northwest Passage may soon fulfill its promise at last. After all, going through the Northwest Passage, as opposed to the Panama Canal, could save as much as 4,000 kilometers. And without the limitations of locks, the passage could conceivably accommodate larger cargo vessels. For certain routes, the Northwest Passage could be faster and cheaper. In 2013, the bulk carrier Nordic Orion, carrying a load of coal, traveled from Vancouver to Finland via the Northwest Passage. This trip saved them 4 days of travel and nearly $200,000, as opposed to using the Panama Canal. As summer sea ice continues to recede, shipping is bound to increase. But the Northwest Passage won't be the next Panama Canal, and here's why. For starters, the water is far too shallow in certain areas. Parts of the passage are just 11 meters deep, a real limitation for big ships. And even today, with modern navigation equipment, the various channels of the passage can be difficult to navigate. Plus, with unpredictable breaking and free-floating sea ice during the summer months, the route is simply not reliable enough to schedule large-scale cargo traffic. The Canadian Arctic currently doesn't have any commercial ports, so refueling and provisioning is a major obstacle. A small fleet of icebreakers is insufficient to support many ships. There are environmental and social concerns, including impact on wildlife habitat and communities, to consider. As of now, the Northwest Passage is seeing an increase in shipping, but definitely not at Panama Canal levels. Most ships using the passage are supplying communities, carrying tourists, or engaged in mining. Few make the transit from one ocean to the other. While the Northwest Passage has not yet met its promise as a shipping route, other routes in the north have potential. The Northern Sea Route, or Northeast Passage, follows the Arctic coast of Russia between East Asia and Western Europe and could reduce travel time by 10 to 15 days for some ships compared to the Panama Canal. It was used briefly during the Soviet era and hasn't been used much since the 1990s. But as Arctic sea ice cover continues to diminish, it may become a viable option for shipping companies. And with a fleet of icebreakers and working ports, Russia looks readier than Canada for Arctic traffic. Perhaps the most startling Panama alternative is one that hasn't been discussed much until recently, the transpolar route. With summer sea ice cover continually reducing, many experts fear a viable route may be open for at least a couple of weeks a year, right over the top of the world. That would be the shortest and deepest route, more or less on a direct line through the North Pole from the Bering Strait to Iceland. So don't hold your breath for the Northwest Passage through northern Canada to be cluttered with cargo ships anytime soon. The ice, navigation, and infrastructure issues have yet to be solved and may not be for the near future. But the long-awaited vision of a sea route from Europe to Asia by ship may indeed be coming true at last. Time alone will tell whether the transpolar route comes to rival the venerable Panama Canal as the preferred shortcut between the Atlantic and the Pacific Oceans.